Hello, my name is Tom Verica. I'm the director and executive producer of Queen Charlotte. I'm sitting here with the amazing Arsema Thomas, who plays Lady Agatha Danbury. And we are here, we're gonna talk about a scene from episode 6 called Crown Jewels.
Lady Danbury.
Your Majesty, thank you so very much for the—
You refused my brother. Give him hope of union, of happiness, then break his heart at my ball, in my home.
Your Majesty, I—
His humor may lack wit, and yes, his condescendence knows no bounds. He is, however, a person of fine character and pure heart. And someone in your position could find much worse options, could they not?
They could indeed, Your Majesty.
My approach to the scene is I really wanted this private moment in a very public place. So, and this being kind of Agatha's departure, you know, I really wanted to sort of hide a young Charlotte in the background. So we were with Agatha as she comes through here, and we see her not making an escape, but I think ready to leave for the night. And I think I wanted that element of surprise that Agatha gets to turn back into Charlotte here and kind of be caught trying to, I think, in working with Arsema is really kind of internally sort of figuring out where Charlotte's going with this and really studying her. And you did. I mean, a lot of it is, you know, it's not, as actors, not what you're saying, it's really what you're listening, because it's acting and reacting. So you really had to sort of be dialed into the journey that she was taking to really see whether you guys are gonna be okay, so.
That's a good point.
What did you feel playing this scene?
It's funny, because the first time I saw it, I thought it was a fight. When I read it, because there's this tension that I didn't understand was coming from. And then it was with your brilliant direction that you said what this was all meant to do, which is like Agatha's not meant to leave here feeling offended or like she has no friend. It's meant to actually feel, let her feel more, I don't know, just calm that it's going to be in someone else's hands.
Yeah.
That she can take it.
Well, but I think you, again, you know, throughout the series, you trying to get through to her, I think you see now, and that's why I say you planted the seed, is that she has now come to a place where you know that real change can happen with the great experiment. But I think even though she's kind of asserting her power, I think there's a knowingness inside Agatha that's like, she gets it now, and kind of what you guys have been through. I think initially, some of the earlier takes, it seemed like it was kind of contentious and there was a bit of friction there, but I think as we kind of heard and worked together and kind of collaborated on what the meaning of this and what was happening, that it really wasn't a point of conflict, that there was a lot of resolution. This is, I believe, the last time that we see these two on screen together.
Yeah.
So I think, I mean, Arsema always nailed it, so, you know, one or two takes was pretty much all she needed.
You're just waiting on India to really get it together in this
get
one.
Get it out, spit it out.
Please, accept my apology. Tell me what I might do in
Adolphus
order to—
Adolphus will survive. What concerns me is what I am to do with you. The fact that you did not come to me with your concerns, your fears regarding your inheritance, your title, the fate of your family, of all the families recently titled.
I apologize, Your Majesty. I only didn't want to place my burdens on top of your own. Yours, which seems so—
We are one crown. His weight is mine, and mine is his. One crown. We rule for the welfare of all our subjects, new and old, rival and foe, titled or not. You tell me my castle walls are too high. I tell you they must be. High as the sky, if necessary, to protect you, to protect all our worthy subjects.
No, I think every moment up until this point, she's like fighting for something, fixing something, doing something for somebody else. And in this moment, it's the very first time that someone says to her, why don't you tell me so that I could help you? And I don't think she's ever had that before. And to see somebody offer it for the very first time, it's like Agatha can rest now because we're at the end of the season. Like she's, she can just go to sleep after this entire night. And I feel like she never gets that kind of sense.
Well, she's been wrestling with this. I mean, even that, the tea scene, you wanted to ask for that help and you kind of take it right up to that line of asking for her help, because you know she could do it, but mm-hmm. I think it is her own journey. And then with, you know, letting her brother off the hook,
yeah,
basically is choosing your own power.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the journey that Agatha needs to take. So young Charlotte seems to be, you know, coming at you initially quite hot. There is, I think, a partnership that's gonna live on into kind of the current day Bridgerton.
Oh, of course, yeah.
I suggest you shift your fear into faith and come to us with your concerns directly. To do otherwise would suggest we are incapable of addressing them, unless that is what you believe, Lady Danbury. You may go. I shall send for you soon.
Your Majesty.
And there was something really poignant about this, because you would think that after the confrontation Agatha has with Adolphus, that that's like the end of her story. And to see it come back around,
yeah,
and it's really about her and Queen Charlotte, I think it just cements this really powerful narrative for this show about, like, it's not about the men, it's about the women and their friendships. And this is the real, at least for Agatha, her love story mm-hmm. is with Charlotte. It's not about Lord Danbury or Ledger or Adolphus, but about Charlotte.